got sunshine.
From the moment she's born, a man's daughter is the center of his universe. You give her love. You give her encouragement. You watch her grow into a strong, confident woman. And then one day, you come face to face with the love of her life.
The Flemings are in the house! Yes!
Oh my God.
Well, looks like he works out quite a bit.
Steffi, get him up here!
Please, please, please. Have a little surprise.
Ta-da!
Is that our Christmas card?
It's all of you!
It says happy holidays and everything.
It says happy holidays?
Yeah.
Oh, I gave the guy the Christmas card. I didn't know he put happy holidays on there. I guess that's on me forever now.
Now, this has been a bit of a return for you to comedy.
Yeah.
What was it like to do that, to come back to that?
It was something I was looking for. You know, Breaking Bad happened and then went into doing All the Way and Trumbo and a couple other things, Infiltrator. And it was important. I was looking for a comedy, but I didn't know what was going to be available to me. And this opportunity came up. And quite frankly, it wasn't the story that got me, because the setup is really very, oh, Midwest dad doesn't like the boyfriend his daughter chooses. You know, it's like, okay, that's so thin that I can't say yes or no to that. I need some meat, you know? So that's when we got together and we start talking about, and I really started to see what this could become and how people can relate to it. And that always has more impact and more effect on me as an actor when I've had more of an experience. And I think I gauge that I think then the audiences will have a better experience. They'll have a ton of laughs in this, but they'll also feel something leaving the theater. You know, they will have invested in these characters and cared about them.
Turns out her boyfriend is this internet zillionaire.
Laird has literally no filter, but he's a really good guy.
Remember that night in the hot tub?
Steph opened up like a flower. You should have seen it.
I shouldn't have seen it, but now I feel like I have.
Mm. No father would want their daughter with this guy.
My instinct is to hug you right now.
Good night.
I don't know what his issues are. Oh my, oh my. I feel like I'm so normal.
I don't like bodyguards around, so I just had Gustav train me.
He's as strange as they come.
Your reaction time is getting quicker.
But what happened to the evasive parkour?
Dad, on Christmas Day, I'm gonna ask Steffi to marry me, and I'd really like your blessing. Yeah.
No.
Give me a couple days to win you over. By Christmas morning, you're going to be calling me son. I'm going to be calling you dad.
Don't think that's going to happen.
I think it's going to, Dad.
I know it won't.
Dad, it will.
Stop that.
What, Dad?
That, stop that.
Dad, what are you talking about?
A big thing that makes it work is the dialogue. This really funny dialogue. You're good at that. You've been doing that, the improv. What was it like working with him and you guys improvising together, and how much was it? How much was there?
It was a lot. We improvised every scene. Like Brian said, we went in and really made sure that the characters were strong and the situation was strong and that we had a clear path to go in. And that's sort of essential. That's what I really learned from, you know, Freaks and Geeks on, you know, through all those comedies I did, that if you have that, if you have solid characters that are emotionally grounded, then it affords you the freedom to really just kind of go wild. And then, you know, and then everybody has to play their role, you know? That's how it works. So these two characters are complete opposites, and that's how we're going to kind of work, you know? I do something that offends him, and, you know, and then he does something that he tries to undermine me or whatever, and that's the dynamic. If he tried to kind of play my role or something, it just fall flat. Yeah. So that's how it worked.
And that's where there was more of a burden on James to keep it going and it be inventive and come up with more and more material. Because my character really is uncomfortable. He's not familiar with the settings and nothing feels good to him. And this man is crazy. I don't know what to make of him. He's really on his heels. So he's not a character who would be rolling with a lot of dialogue. He's more reactionary. So it took his ability to ad lib, to to really think in character and ad lib and go, keep it going, stretch it, grow it, push it. And you'll see in most of the scenes, I'm reacting to this man like, I don't believe where I am. You know, it's mostly that. So he was carrying me for the most of the movie. His back is sore. He had to see a chiropractor because he was carrying me for the most of the movie.
It was rough, this guy.
Yeah.
You could be dating anyone. Why Laird?
He makes me really happy.
He is wrapping his tentacles around every member of this family.
Because of his influence, your mother has lost her mind.
Look at this.
It's called twerping.
This is not someone we want our daughter marrying.
I am going to take this octopus down.
Been public enemy since you fought P.E. with
boom! Shaka-laka-laka!
This house until we knock it down. So turn up.
You're not going to say anything to Stephanie about the proposal, right?
Is that a drone?
Laird is spying on us.
What?
Do not mess with me! Ah! Oh!